As you know, I had quite the plans for the weekend. And I had a blast. At home, laying in my couch, watching Netflix, and eating ice cream. I turned my phone off, because I wanted a break. But that doesn't mean the world decided to take a break. The universe goes on. And during the weekend, some exciting developments took place. And I am going to tell you all about them, because I owe it to you guys. New week, new us. Let's orbit beyond the blue. Orbit. Beyond the blue. Problems. The only thing that appear out of nowhere. Could it ever be $1 million? $1 million appearing out of nowhere? No. A bottle of scotch? No. The love of my life suddenly walking into my life? Well, let's not even go there. A small good thing like a cup of coffee? Never. You see, good things do not appear out of nowhere. Except, when it comes to the cosmos, it's different. Yes, a star died, but from its cocoon, emerged a sucker. A cosmic sucker. And we have found it. In an exciting development, astronomers have found a new black hole, in a galaxy adjacent to the Milky Way. They are calling it a cosmic needle in a haystack. And this black hole isn't an ordinary one. Classified as dormant, this cosmic sucker appears to have been born out of nowhere. Yes, without the explosion of a dying star, it seems. And not just that. Scientists stated that this black hole differs from all other known black holes, as it is X-ray quiet. It means that the black hole is not emitting powerful X-ray radiation, indicative of gobbling up nearby material, with its strong gravitational field. Yes, it seems to be rather quiet, giving the impression that it wasn't born of a supernova. Stellar mass black holes are formed after massive stars reach the end of their lives and collapse under their own gravity. However, what baffles astronomers is the fact that the star that gave rise to the black hole, in the Large Magellanic Cloud Galaxy, vanished without any sign of a powerful explosion. Dubbed the FDS-243, the black hole was discovered from observations obtained by the European Southern Observatory's Very Large Telescope, VLT. An extremely luminous and hot blue star, with a mass about 25 times that of the Sun, orbits with this black hole, in a stellar marriage. The researchers believe the companion star, in the binary system, eventually also will become a black hole, and could merge with the other one. Now, I can talk more about this, but honestly, I feel you have all the information you need. Hence, moving on to the next development. The James Webb Space Telescope was recently used to observe the Phantom Galaxy, which lies about 32 million light years away, according to NASA. New data and images have started pouring in, as the world's most powerful observatory has begun its operation. Recently, astronomer Judy Schmidt produced a new image of the Phantom Galaxy by processing the data available from Webb observations. Dubbed Messier 74 or NGC 628, the galaxy has been photographed using Webb's mid-infrared instrument, which helped peer through the thick cosmic dust. The image shows the galaxy in the mid-infrared wavelength of light, which makes new stars and structures of the galaxy stand out. Many astronomers also believe that this galaxy has an intermediate mass black hole embedded at its center. The sharpness of the image can be determined by comparing it with the Hubble telescope's image, which is a composite of the data collected in 2003 and 2005. But if you think Webb is the only one stealing the spotlight, well, Hubble is not over yet. The father of all telescopes released a bizarre galaxy mirror. There's something very odd about this image from the Hubble Space Telescope. If you look closely, you can see two almost mirror image, orange-colored galaxies, seemingly connected by a long filament. Fascinatingly, that's not two galaxies at all, but one, named SGASJ143845+145407. It just appears to be two, thanks to the way the gravity of a massive object, like a cluster of galaxies, distorts the space that distant light travels through. Imagine putting a heavy weight on a trampoline, where the weight represents the galaxy cluster, and the trampoline mat represents spacetime. Now roll some marbles from one side of the trampoline to the other. Their normally straight paths will seem to curve along different paths, not unlike rays of light, through distorted space. Called gravitational lensing, this quirk of gravity can be used to magnify the light of background galaxies that would be too distant to otherwise see in much detail, but what do I know? Orbit. Beyond the blue.